The improvisations that we make is of really high quality, and so that means that we need to be, as musicians, really thinking about things like the shape of the piece that we're making, of the structure of the piece.
用一个主题 motif 下去做发展，除了有音乐的能力之外，专业能力之外，在即兴方面有团队的这个合作，在曲子的架构上，它也必须要有某一种能力。
你必须要再更仔细的去聆听在这个场所场域里面每个人所发出来的声音，关照到彼此，然后去发出声音，发出比较和谐的声音，或者是说让大家听起来比较舒服的声响，从这样的声音去建立彼此的关系。
So it feels that the improvisations maybe travel a little bit and that they go on a journey. The professional musicianAnd the person with dementia, they go on a journey together. I think it's important to have those solo moments. I think that the whole group pieces are important to make everybody feel that they belong to things, but then within that, we don't have the opportunity to see, you know, the amazing personality of this lady or the gentleness of this gentleman. It's the individual pieces, the solos and the duets are a way just really let each individual person shine.
观察下来，他非常喜欢音乐的那个临场感。不同的地方可能就是一对一的互动，比如说在吹奏的时候，啊，对着你吹，然后他跟着敲击，跟着打拍子，然后让他有肢体活动，他很 enjoy 在那个里头，非常的开心。尤其是我在帮他换穿衣服的时候，他怎么说？他说好像是要去做女婿。
之前在高中的时候也有去安养院，那个时候的我们就是准备了很多像台湾民谣的歌曲在他们身旁演奏，但这次我觉得很不一样的是用一个即兴的方式。我们学古典音乐会想说，哎，这时候作曲家到底想要表达是什么，我们身为演奏家想要把他的想要表达的东西表现出来，但在即兴的这个当下很特别的是它是一个语言，彼此都想要跟对方互动。
你只要去就对了，你只要去你就会留下来。因为那个对一个音乐家的震撼是不可言喻的。
For the musicians, a way for us to meet people that we would never work with, that wouldn't be part of our lives. And then we alsofind a place for ourselves in society that's much broader and much bigger than just being a performer on a stage as well.